Dispose of the materials by placing them into a regular waste receptacle.
Before cleaning a blood or body fluid spill, assemble the materials required for dealing with the spill prior to putting on gloves.
Dispose of the materials.
Inspect the area around the spill thoroughly for splatters or splashes. Restrict the activity around the spill until the area has been cleaned and disinfected and is completely dry.
Dispose of the materials by
put on gloves, and if there is a possibility of splashing, wear a gown and facial protection, such as a mask and eye protection or face shield.
Dispose of the materials.
When cleaning, confine and contain the spill by covering the spill with absorbent material, such as paper towel or chemical spill powder. Wipe up the spill using disposable towels. This is an important step, as disinfectant will not be effective if applied directly to blood or body fluids.
Dispose of the materials
by placing them into a regular waste receptacle. If the soiled materials are so wet that blood can be squeezed out of them, then they must be disposed of into the biomedical waste container, which is a yellow bag.
Dispose of the materials.
Flood the entire spill area with a hospital-grade disinfectant and allow it to stand for the amount of time recommended by the manufacturer. Wipe up the area again using disposable towels and discard into regular waste receptacles. Be very careful to avoid splashing or generating aerosols during the cleanup. Remove gloves and other protective equipment, if worn, and discard into waste receptacles. Remove gown, if worn, and discard into linen bag or waste container. Clean your hands using alcohol-based hand rub. If your hands are visibly soiled, you must use soap and water to clean them.
Dispose of the materials. After cleaning, remove waste,
handling plastic bags from the top, and do not compress bags with your hands. Document the spill incident.
Dispose of the materials by placing them into a regular waste receptacle.